हेलो दोस्तों, वेलकम टू लिखो स्टेनो एकेडमी। दोस्तों, आप चैनल को सब्सक्राइब कर सकते हैं और अपने फ्रेंड्स में या ग्रुप्स में इस चैनल को रेकमेंड कर सकते हैं डेली डिक्टेशंस के लिए, और स्टेनोग्राफी से रिलेटेड कोई डाउट्स हैं तो उनके सॉल्यूशंस के लिए। आज आपको मैं सर जीडी बिस्ट मैगज़ीन से एक ट्रांसक्रिप्शन दूंगा जिसकी स्पीड मोर देन 105 WPM होगी। सो आप अच्छे से उसे लिखिएगा और इसे ट्रांसक्राइब ज़रूर करिएगा। तो आपको डिक्टेशन दे रहा हूँ मैं, बी रेडी फॉर इट।
सर, ड्यूरिंग द लास्ट 10 ईयर्स थिंग्स हैव गॉन फ्रॉम बैड टू वर्स, नॉट बिकॉज ऑफ द फॉल्ट ऑफ एनीबडी, बट बिकॉज ऑफ सर्कमस्टेंसेज विच हैव टू बी टेकन इंटू कंसिडरेशन। इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल फॉर ए मिडिल क्लास मैन टूडे to send his children to school, especially in urban areas and even in rural areas. Today, we talk of equality of opportunities. Where is the equality of opportunities today? A man has to pay rupees 30 to send his child to school. A middle class man cannot pay rupees 30 for sending his child to school. Also, if he wants to get his child admitted to a school, he has to find a premium for that, and the poor man can never think of spending his child to school. Under these circumstances, the sooner we realize the importance of compulsory and free primary education, the better for us. Today, not even where compulsory and free education has been introduced, it is not possible for the parents of these children to take advantage of this free and compulsory primary education. I know of numerous cases where it is not possible for parents even to spend for the books of their children. It is not possible for them to send their children to the school, which is a long way off. Provision has been made in this bill to the effect that an area will be specified area within which there will be a school, and it will be the duty of the local authority to see that there is a school there. I do not know what will be the area, but I hope that the authorities concerned will bear it in mind that in the case of the people who are to be called upon to send their children to the school, it would be possible for the children to walk to the school. Sir, it is not enough if we make primary education free and compulsory. So far as this country is concerned, it is necessary that the wherewithal for educating the children is also provided by the government. In this country, there has been the first, the second and third plans. There will be more 5-year plans. We have been providing for a number of welfare schemes. I do not know whether these welfare schemes must get precedence over free and compulsory education. I can understand efforts being made for finding employment for the unemployed people. I can understand efforts being made for finding shelter for the people who have no shelter. But I cannot understand provision being made for welfare schemes when there is no education given to the children, when it is not possible for the parents to look after their children. He is prepared to wait for food. He is prepared to wait for shelter, but we should not expect him to wait for primary education to his children if he has no means to educate his children. Sir, the question of free and compulsory primary education can only be neglected at our peril. Reference was made to Article 45 of the Constitution, wherein 10 years period was provided within which free and compulsory primary education was to be introduced. I am very sorry, the importance of this was not recognized. Sir, in this country, when a universal franchise was granted, the peril of granting that universal franchise was understood, and in spite of understanding that risk was taken. So, the verdict of the people today is not the considered opinion of the people, but it is an expression of faith. If anybody is prepared to say today that when elections are held, we see the considered opinion of the people, I would say he is sadly mistaken. What we find today is that elections are held in an expression of faith, and because of great personality like Panditji is there, the people have this faith and they give expression to the faith when they go to the polls. That is because in this country, 80% of the population are unable to read and write. Therefore, it is not possible for them to come to a decision after taking all the pros and cons of the situation. Instead of realization of this fact, it has not been possible, maybe for good reasons, to introduce free and compulsory primary education in this country, and the period stipulated has been extended. In this country, there have been violent demonstrations. We have introduced democracy in this country, but every man and woman in this country must realize the implications of democracy. It must be realized that democracy is not only a mode of government, it is a way of life, and every member of this country has to be shaped in such a way as to make him realize that unless we make democracy a mode of living, it will not be possible to retain democracy in this country. In recent years, we have found violent demonstrations on a number of questions, and that is only on account of the fact that there is almost 80% illiteracy and there have been disparities. I do not refer to only one party who has been exploiting these illiterate people, who has been misguiding them. Therefore, the question of free and compulsory primary education in the light of this background in this country deserves greater attention than what it has got so far. If free and compulsory education had been introduced in this country in 10 years time, as was convinced of in Article 45, then at least the newcomers would have had some 4 years of education. They would have learnt to read and write. In this country, during the last 10 or 11 years, more than 7 crores of people have come of this age, and majority of them have not been able to read and write at least their own language.
तो दोस्तों ये थी डिक्टेशन 1000 वर्ड्स की 100